But this is right.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. Well, that's how it works. I'll do something.
Sour cream.
I was in a B club and Glee club and even the chess team. Only question I ever thought was hard. What do I like her or do I like Picard? Spend every weekend at the Renaissance Fair. Got my name on my underwear. They see me strolling, they're laughing, and rolling their eyes because I'm so white and nerdy. Just because I'm white and nerdy. Just because I'm white and nerdy. All because I'm white and nerdy. Holy cow, I'm white and nerdy. I wanna pull with the gangsters. Oh, well, it's obvious I'm white.
Oh, God. It has been a bit, and I know that you guys have been waiting for a very long time, and I'm so sorry. Technical difficulties out the ass, but back for a little bit. I hope this show goes well. I really do. It's been a while since I pointed, so there we go. There we go. Now you guys can read stuff. Oh, I don't want to deal with that anymore at all. I know. I know it's been a long time, and I know that the counter had been reset. It was something like 40 minutes. And I appreciate all you hanging out as long as you did, because it had been a long time, and I know you're like, where's he at? And just so many technical difficulties, but I know you guys have been talking, so it's awesome. Trenzorg, what's going on? Dark Ambrose, great to see you, buddy. For those of you that have been hanging out...
Water's in there, Superman's in there.
Right. For those of you that have been hanging out on Instagram, we've been gotten a little bit closer. You know, Barry, how you doing, buddy? How you doing? But Instagram seemed to be the place to be for a while. So those of you that have been hanging out on Instagram with me, thank you so much. Except for you, Modder, because I am so envious of your collection. It just pisses me off every day. Because you buy quality, I buy quantity. And whereas I have, you know, a big old box of toys that cost me $50, you have one Star Wars figure that is out of this world for $50. So, what's up, heroes? I know you messaged me earlier, man. I was still having the technical difficulties, man. But I appreciate you hanging out. S Fox, you know who you are, man. You know you're my guy. And I don't know Money's in here anymore, but I saw him earlier comment. It's always good when the streamers pop back in, because it makes me feel, because I watch them, you know, I watch the streamers when I'm not streaming, and I haven't been for 66 days, I learned today. But when the streamers pop in my stream, it makes me feel good. It makes me feel a little different, because it's like, oh, wow, these people that I watch on TV, you know, the big old looky-loo box, these people that I watch, they're talking to me. So it makes me feel different and a little bit special. So it's awesome when you got that. Who's this guy? Al Sunday, what's up, man? Is that Sunday Heat? Is that who that is? I think you said you had to change your names. I'm not sure. Kimber, what's going on, girl? I don't think I've ever personally talked to Kimber. I just know she's always in that Saints fans room, and it's always good to see her in there. And like Money always says, watch the Saints fan. It's Lipwitz. I think it's Lipwitz or... I can't remember the name, but it's the Saints fan. The dude is the hardest working new streamer ever in the history of anything. So it's always good when he's on. I love watching this stuff, even if I don't interact. That man right there deserves way more followers than I have. So I really hope that you guys, the next time you see him, I don't care if there's five people in here, all of you go, you be quiet, all of you go and watch the Saints fan. That man puts so much heart and soul into this. Barker Sniff! I like your name, man. That's cool. I know that I've missed so many comments while I'm trying to get that little bitty rant out. But Council Stood Together! That's right, man. We really did on Instagram. It was so nice during my surgery and my recovery to be able to pop on and be able to interact with you guys that I've grown so close to. So it was really awesome that you guys have actually followed me on Instagram. And I'll get into that. The more people that get in here, because I know everybody's going to ask questions and all that. And what's up, Jan? Oh, good. I can never... like, it's been a while, so the names don't really connect unless you're S-Fox. Where do I know this face from? There he is. Right there. That man. The hardest working man in Ustream ever, hands down. Please go follow him. Go watch his show. It is so entertaining. It is so well thought. That, I mean, when people come in mine, and I got 100 people rolling in here, it's truly, it's just because you guys like seeing this crap behind me. You don't care what I have to say. You don't care what I do. You're just like, oh, what's that shit back there in the back? Tell me all about this. Are these Power Rangers? Yeah, they're Power Rangers. But that man up there, the Saints fan, he actually sits down and plans out games, like the classic games that your mom and dad used to watch, you know, with Dick Clark and all those.
Smart games.
The smart games. Yeah, the intelligent stuff. So, yeah, okay, I figured it was. Watching you on PS4. Yeah, that's right. You said you're getting a PS4, so that's awesome. Horderick! as soon as I saw that, I go, Hodor. 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 Hey, from Scotland, UK, how are you? I'm all right, Betty Boop. I'm doing okay. Like I touched on a little bit, I had major surgery, and then after my surgery, I had a lot of complications. And I'll go into the whole story probably around, we'll wait till 45. And so if you guys hang out, if you guys want to come back, I will tell you the whole story. And that's the only time I will ever tell you the story, and that's all you get. So I like your Ninja Turtle Power Ranger stuff. Thank you very much, game man. I like your name. That's great. Supernatural, show us the Power Ranger Morpher. Wow, you're just up there. You're just looking around, aren't you, Supernatural? Super the Natural. I would like a cup of ginger tea. All right, yeah, I could go for that too. You know what I couldn't go for is the
apple cider vinegar.
Yeah, apple cider vinegar. So at lunch today, I went to this barbecue shop, and I know you guys are all been waiting for that. You're like, no, not this pile of toys back here. No, not that. You're like, what did he have for lunch? Well, I'm going to tell you. So, and this will coincide with the story later, but they had vinegar, like barbecue sauce. So like the main ingredient was vinegar. And I'm like, I'll dip my barbecue in there. Tastes just like apple cider vinegar, and oh my god, it's still in the back of my throat, and it kind of hurts a little bit. Yeah, Revel Tech, man, that stuff is so expensive and so good. I saw your Fraggle. I popped in your stream earlier, and I was like, I gotta get this stuff started, because it took way longer than I anticipated to get this up and going. I'm so sorry, because I always love your show. That's another one. I know, Vinny, I know. What's up, Russ? How you doing, buddy? What's that face? Why have you been gone so long? Spartan, great question. And like I said, around 45, I'm going to tell you the whole thing. I had surgery, and I had complications after the surgery. Fuck USA! Depends, man. Sometimes, yes, I agree. Sometimes it's just a complete hellhole. So, and sometimes I agree. Pretend to be Barack Obama doing heroin. I tell you what, I don't have to pretend anything. Because deep in the toy collection, I have Jedi Obama. Yeah, that's what's in my collection. So there you go, Jedi Obama. And I know that if Darkseid's in here, the dude is complete jealous. And he should be, because who has this? Bishop, what's going on, buddy? I know, it's been a long time since I've seen you, man. But I get to catch up with you on Instagram, so that's good. Show your tits, maybe later, Hodor. You never know how this night's going to turn out. So stick around, there may be some boobs flashing. Double? What? Sorry, Russ. Easy, Superman. Uh-oh, you're getting Modder all ticked off now. You don't want to do that. The dude's dropping awesome figures left and right. Grabbing that cat saying, oh, see, I told you, man. As soon as you said it, I'm like, that's what I did. Yeah, I don't have internet access, but I made internet access. Twerk! You gotta hold on for that. It's my first night back in a long time, so twerking is towards the end. But if you got here in the beginning, you would have been right on time. What is up, Blackout 88? Man, I like that name. That is a good name right there. Might hunt you down. What? What does that have to do with anything? No fan set. You getting Batman, Jizzy? Yes, I am, man. Actually, yesterday I went to GameStop and I reserved my copy for it because you get the expansion play and all that stuff. So, without that, that's a good way to segue into this. While I was there, Russ, to be honest, I missed everybody as well. You never know how close you become to some of these people. Like Barry, I've actually missed Barry. I was actually worried about him for a while because one of the last shows that I had, Barry was having a little bit of complications, and I was kind of worried about him, you know, because I know when you're young and stuff like that happens. A little bit, Spartan, a little bit. But I know that Barry's having a little bit of problems or whatever, and I was kind of worried about him a little bit. But anyway, while I was at GameStop, the guy behind the counter talked me into buying this, and I know, son, I need your...
It was so hard.
Yeah, it was so hard to talk me into this, too. Son, I need your collection. Gaza, it has taken a long time to acquire this, and honestly, it just looks like a lot of stuff. It's not really. What's your IG? It's right here at the bottom. I keep it at the bottom in big bold print so you guys can go if you want to and check out the stuff. Sweet shirt. Thank you, man. Of course, LeVar Burton. Anyway, so show us your power. I will in just a minute, man. Just let me get through this, and I promise you I will because you asked earlier. But anyway, he sold me this, which is the Sonic. It doesn't say Sonic, but it is the Sonic Batarang replica for the Arkham Knight. And... they want $30 for it, and it said it doesn't come out until the same day as the game, but they had 4 in stock at this one, so if you guys really want it, you could probably pick it up. Mr. Brandt! What is up, Mr. Brandt? Just hanging out. Got my loot crate. Dark, it's a good thing you brought that up, man, because I have 2 of them. I haven't even opened yet. Howard Stern, small penis. Okay. All right. I'll give you that. The vinegar barbecue. Oh, that's what you're talking about. Yeah, no, it's the... I threw up apple cider vinegar, and if anybody's ever drank apple cider vinegar, you know that it's bad to begin with, and the reverse is even worse. Write that down. That is a catchphrase. I don't know what that says. Fashero Radio 80 Show Sat 14. That sounds like a good time to me, man. Do you have the 10-inch? No, I don't. I know what you're talking about, too. For some reason, Nintendo thinks that their product line doesn't stink, and they can charge all this crazy amount of money for some damn Nintendo figures, and I won't pay it. But I agree, it's awesome. Got a hard-on now. I know you do, Super Dave. By the way, Super Dave, it was awesome to see you. It was finally good to... Like, I'd heard you talk before, and I'd interacted before, but I never actually got to see your face. And any time that I get to see somebody that pops in here's face, it was like, oh, now I can put the face with what they say or with, you know, how they interact with me. So it's always good to see that. What did I do with it? There it is. So this is the Batarang out of the box. Of course, I opened it because... I busted the back off of it. Is that still a saying? Do we still say that? But there we go. That's the Batarang, and this is what it does. So I know it's kind of blurry or whatever, but it's got the bat symbol, and then it's got the sort of like the sonar enhance. So whenever you do that. Also, it folds like that. I guess that's the bat storage. I don't know where you would keep 2 of these or whatever, so I guess you just got 1. Baba booey! And then it also, it's got the kick out on it, so you can be like, you know, like, ah, the guy's getting away, and then chuck it. Shit, they're out of stock. Oh, you're talking about the Batarang. I got lucky, man. He said they had 3. I guess because they're $30 a pop, and a lot of people don't want to put that, especially on top of a $60 game that's going to have another $30 in expansion later. So I kind of agree if you don't pick it up, but it is kind of neat, and I wish it came with like a wall display or some kind of mount, but it doesn't. Have you heard of the WCIS show, Rebel? Yes, of course I have. I'm a huge fan of Tove and Hev and Uncle Eric. I love those guys. I watch them as much as I can. They get on so late that I have to go to bed. So I get on like right as they get on. And I'm like, hey, what's up? And they're like, yeah, what's up? And I'm just like, oh, I got to go to sleep. So it's sad, but I absolutely love those guys. Daddy Pep, what is going on, man? I just got Dragon Sword. It's awesome. I heard it's awesome. Speaking of that, you're back in here. Let me get this Morpher because I know you asked. And I try to accommodate everybody. Open a loot crate. I'm going to try. We got limited time and a lot of stuff. We're not going to even get to it all. But there's the Morpher. This is the Legacy Morpher that came out, I think, two years ago. And it came with all 5 of the original coins, all the Power Ranger coins. You okay?
Yeah.
And it does this. Thank you, Super Dave. it plays the whole song. It's really cool. It's actually metal. And right now in most Toys R Us, you can get Tommy's Legacy Morpher, which comes with the White Tiger Zord and the Dragon Zord coin. They're really cool. I agree, Vinny. I really do. I think Arkham is going to be the, it is the granddaddy. It's the last one. But actually, like, Arkham Knight himself looks so cool, man. I can't wait to play it. That's why I had to pre-order it. What do you think of the fake Joker cremated? Honestly, I don't think this one's going to be about Joker. I really don't. I know that is his, you know, arch enemy of all time. Moneymaker! What's up, man? That man right there, he's the one that got me through a lot of this 66 days off. Being able to watch him and talk to him as a person, because it's different when you're on stream. When you're on stream, you have to be on your game. You have to be constantly moving and entertaining, so it's different. But to talk to people behind the scenes, it is so awesome to be able to interact that way. Money, thank you so much. I know I haven't been able to express it that way, but you're one of the guys. You're one of the good guys, dude. So you're awesome. I'm gonna follow. Thank you very much, Betty Boop. I know I missed a couple of your comments. It goes fast, and I have a lot of stuff to get off my chest. So
No Time likes you too.
Who?
No Time.
Also. No Time. What's up, No Time? It's been a bit. No Time. It's been, and I'm gonna say this a lot. It's been 66 days. First time watcher. I saw that, man. I really appreciate you popping in. It's one of those streams that kind of, I feel that it goes too fast. Regardless if I'm on for 2 hours or 4 hours or whatever, I think that it always goes too fast. I try to keep up with this stuff. Requested. Okay, cool. Thank you very much. I accept most people's whenever you follow me, and I follow you back if you got some cool stuff. I mean, and I'll be honest right up front, if it's you and your family, it's not for me, because it's not a personal thing. It's not that I don't like you. It's just that I don't know your kids, so it doesn't affect me. But you're more than welcome to follow me, yell at me, send me messages. It's all good. But thank you so much, Rebel. Reballer. Rebeller. I can't say it right. Tell me later. Well, he's not here, so go for it. You mean you like my ugly mug? Hell yeah, I like everybody. Nobody's really ugly, okay? Nobody's really ugly. There is beauty in everybody, and there's somebody out there for everybody. So you may go look in the mirror like, damn, I'm an ugly person. But walking down the street, somebody be like, damn, I can't wait to get that big piece of meat in my mouth. I mean, I don't know. Like I said, one day I could wake up gay. I just haven't seen the right guy yet. No curls in the squat rack. What is up? It has been way too long since I've seen that name. Awesome. Thank you so much. Yeah, Reading Rainbow all the way. Money, those prank calls. I know, dude. And see, that's the problem. I mentioned WCIS earlier, and I love those guys, but they're on every night, so you're not going to miss it. But Money is on once a week, so I have to stay up late whenever he's on, because I'm just like, oh, I know something good's going to happen if I turn it off right now. So, Loot Crate opening on cam. Are you going to do it, or you want me to do it? I'm not following that. What's up, Great Room? Thank you very much, Immortal. I like your name, dude. That's awesome. Immortal Anarchy. Great. You still need a dollar. I do, Super Dave. I do. Make sure you pass that along to me. Plug IG. That's right. And I'll go ahead and warn anybody that follows me on Instagram. You end up getting the rest of the Nerd Council. I know that sounds so weird. Yeah, Money. I mean, you're one of the top guys. You will pretty much always be. So, but anyway... Yeah, if you follow me on Instagram, you definitely get S-Fox, because he follows pretty much everybody back.
Hello, Superman!
And you pretty much will get Modder, probably Sunday Heat. Those guys always pop up, and they will follow you. So you're going to get me and then a few others, but it's all one great big circle. So it's awesome. Shut up! Duck or Die Nasty. I actually like that. That's a cool name, man. That kind of rolls off the tongue. That sounds like something you say right before you hit somebody in the back of the head with a 2x4. Duck or Die Nasty! Are you gay? No, I'm not. But like I said, you never know. One day I could wake up and be like, I want that guy's Peter right here. And you never know. So I keep my options open. I miss you. J-Dub, I have too. And I'm not Xing out anybody else. But that man right there, I think that I've connected to in another level. Because, I don't really want to talk about a lot of his personal stuff. But I know what he's going through. I happened to the same thing for me. And I know what it feels like to just sit there and just not know what's next. So it's awesome to see you, J-Dub. Again, you know how I feel, buddy. But yeah, hang out. Hopefully we can get a smile on your face. I drink apple cider vinegar to lose weight. You the man, Russ. You the man. I tell you what, man. Just to put yourself in my position, next time you drink it, just make yourself throw up so you can just have that experience. And then we'll talk apple cider stories. I think it just came out the closet. Awesome. That is awesome. Welcome out if, like I said, I support anybody for whatever they want to do. So, what is up, 08B4D158? You're going to have to tell me how to say that, man. Shut up. There he is again. Shut up, Ducker Dynasty. Warning. There you go. That's right. Yeah, he's a Gambit lover. Carl! Gah! Yeah, I know you're waiting for that, Vinny. You're just setting that up, just waiting. What Star Wars variants do you have? Night Triangle. Honestly, I don't really... I collect for the covers now. I really don't even read the comics. I just walk down the comic aisle and be like, that's a cool cover, and then pick it up. Because it's really way too expensive to keep on buying the long run. You want to buy trades. Yeah, like pick up a cover you like, or if something big happens in the issue, buy that one. But to have a line of comic books is so expensive these days. Oh, I missed you too. Thanks. I thought of it. I do. I really do. I like your name. That is honest. And most people that know me know that I speak right to you. I don't bullshit. I don't sugarcoat it. But I actually do. I like that name. And that one's a good name, too. You pumped about Batman? I am, too, dude. Like I said, I had to go and pre-order because I had to have it. Your room looks cool. Thank you very much, London Troll. Oh, I just got this weird vision in my head of the London Troll. What are those shoes in the background? Dope Boy, 35. Those are the Nike Air Mags from 2015 from Back to the Future. Buckers! See, I hate it when I'm gone for a long time because, like, the names that follow me on Instagram, they're there, you know, those people. But Buckers, man, you slipped out. Clancy! Those guys, man, I miss them so much because they don't interact anywhere else. So it's great. You on crack? I had a little bit of Mountain Dew. Does that count? Yes, they are, Russ. Great eye, dude. Devin on this dick, got him. That, see, what's funny is the got him started after I had to take a break for a while. So I would be like watching the streams and people would be like, got him. Like, what the hell is that? Why didn't I ever get the got him? Thank you for giving me that. What a room, Elvira rocks. Oh, are you an Elvira fan? Or is that your name? I'm curious. Uncharted fan, hi, you are so lovely. Well, you are lovely as well. Did you see the Uncharted 4 trailer? Oh, it looks so good. I know, Clancy, I know. It's been a long time. Like I said, it's been 66 days since my last broadcast. It has been so long. No Moneymaker 254, just Ben Ustream. What? Junior Bad Boy. I like that t-shirt. Cool. Thank you, man. I believe this is Target. I think you can still get them. Can you still get them? I don't know. I think so. Did I make the circle? Of course you made the circle. You know what? It's been a long time. It has been 66 days since I gave out the big kapow new, nerd circle. Warlock of Slayer. What is that? Did you have to get a new name? Did you get banned? What happened? So... let's do it. We just hit 100, around 100. There might be like 89 people, whatever. It's first time watching. Thank you very much. Here we go. It's been so long since I've given out a nerd circle. So all of you today, get a nerd circle. We good? Are you ready? Here we go. It's going to be a big... all right, everybody hold your breath. Look, I know that guy's breathing. All right, stop breathing. Hold your breath. Here we go. Yeah, baby, it's been so long. So everybody in here got a free nerd circle. Write that down. Put that thing in your pocket. Take it to the bank. They will give you 39 cents at any retailer. Take it up there. Did you see the Batmobile? I know, right? But after I dropped the money for the Batarang, I just could not do it. There's no way. So what is up, Cruel Zoms? I like the name, man. I got like 5 minute delay on your comments. I know, Superman. I know. Is the voice off? Is is my lips off from what I'm saying? Just want to say, miss you, Nerdy. I miss you too, Superman. I really do. Godless hooligan. One time I farted an entire plum. You need to be on that commercial for the new markers that smell or whatever, that has the blueberry that farts into the system. That sounds like a job for you, man. Dog, you're the coolest guy alive. Thank you, man. I don't think so, but thank you for thinking that. Good to see you back. I know, Clancy. It's been a long time. Rothersh. I don't know what that means. Chip Hazards. Chip. Oh, dude. I wanted to watch that movie. I've been wanting to watch it, but it's not on Netflix and it's not on any of the illegal sites. So now I got to go out and buy it. Awesome name. Thank you, man. Thank you. Seen a cool Nightwing cover I like. What are you talking about? Comic book? Missed your energy. I went away. So crap. Come so hard. Oh, yeah. Sweet, baby. Blow it out there. Probably you stream is fucked. Yeah, that seems to be the normal. That's my name. I'm a rock chick. Love metal music. That's an awesome name, man. That's the queen. That's right. The Elvira is the queen. So the fact that that's your real name, that is awesome. Yay! What's up, bro? What's up, Cruel Zombie? I really like your name, dude. You're not a streamer, are you? I came a little... S-Fox, don't you always... Aren't you always a little fapping? let's do something, man. Let's see. What do we got? Oh, he's not in here. So, anybody that's new to the stream, they know that whenever I'm in here, I try to talk about toys and anything comic book, pretty much anything nerdy. That's why it's a nerdy effect. I picked up this. This is the new Raphael for the new Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles TV show. And I'm a huge Raph fan. I love him. So this one is hot-headed Raph. And I'm like, all right, I got to have it. Spotted dick! I actually had some, but I didn't really like it because I know it needs custard. Pre-ordered Fallout. Oh, I know, dude. Now, I'm curious because I asked somebody, I didn't get the answer. I know that the special edition comes with a Pip-Boy, but I don't know if you can actually wear it, because if it does, then I want it. Cockstuffer Manston. What is up, Manston? Are you a cockstuffer? Are you calling me one? Because you got to be Pacific. Rim Jobber. since I put it off a little bit, let's go ahead and open this up, take a look at it, see what it is. Do a nerd circle, la 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 la. We'll hold off, but we'll get you one. So, like my man Darkseid always says, bust the back off that mud. Killer! Oh, what is up, man? Ah, see, that's one of my guys. I miss that guy. Nikki Belly, my dream girl. No, I like Paige. Paige is my girl. I like her a lot. I wanted to buy her toy, but her face was all derpy. Hello from London. What is up, Magic Matt? What's going on in London tonight? I know it's like 1 o'clock in the morning there or something, man. I know it's close. Were you excited to hear about Final Fantasy? I really was. I'm not a huge Final Fantasy fan, but I absolutely do love the idea of it. And I think that Final Fantasy, was it called? Reborn or Remastered or something like that. It looks so good. Thank you, New York Mets. I appreciate that, buddy. Are you ginger? No, I hope I don't look ginger. This is brown, man. So there he is with the plastic. And because of my man Chip Hazard that's hanging out in there, dedicate this dip to you. Ah, oh, I miss that so much, Barry. I really do. They decided to strap him in with this tie because they think that he's going to escape and start messing up the toy store or something. So they think that kids really... I mean, like, I get it. I'm an adult. I understand that. And I know what to do with this, but this is intended for a kid, and they're giving this strapped in there for a kid. How stupid is that? Yeah, you can wear it. Oh, sweet. Then I guess I have to get it. Cracker Jack! There we go. There he is. And I love this new line. I think they're great with the toys. They're a lot like the classics, but they're more poseable. But I like them because they're kind of cool. They're kind of stumpy and it looks good. And he just looks really pissed off. What the fuck are you opening? Yeah, man. There's a lot of stuff in my collection that I don't open, but I do reserve some things just to open. So do you like the DC Lobo character? I do. I don't read. I rarely read comic books anymore, but I like the look of Lobo. No! Delay in comments is ridiculous. I'm sorry, Superman. I hope nobody else is having that. It happens because it's Ustream. So there we go. That's Raph out the box. And not like the big figures, but his hands are all clamped. Yeah, Nightwing comic. I'm sorry, man. I know I asked that so long ago. Dark, did you put it on Instagram? I'm curious because I want to see it now. You are a sympathetic rim chopper. Sabretooth one. Yeah, you know it. All right, so I do like this. I think that Michael Bay dropped the ball when it came to making the toys for the movie, because with the RAF that came from the movie, they didn't even put a spot to hold his size. Not at all. No reason why. I couldn't understand it. But number one, he can hold the Psy and he can carry him. So you can have this figure that looks badass without having to have the weapons out, because that's what RAF is. You put your phone into Pip-Boy and it works. Oh, really? See, I didn't get to see that. I missed that part of E3. 45, time for the story. You're right, Transorg, it is. We just got done opening this. This is RAF. This is hot-headed RAF from the new Turtles from the Nickelodeon show. I watched a little bit of the show. I think the show's pretty good. So I would recommend it because it's fun. Nicky D! What is up, girl? Oh, so good to see you. There's another streamer. Like I said, it always brings a smile to my face when a streamer comes in because it's like I watch them, and now they're watching me, so I actually feel important even though I'm not important at all. Let me get to this. RAF also comes with the extra weapons like he did back in the day, back in the 80s with the toys. So we love you too, Nikki, and Grandma Nick, and Nick, and all the other characters that are there, and all the other people that have come. Thank you so much for popping in. But, okay, so I'll go ahead and tell the story, and I know I'm going to go ahead and miss the comments, and I apologize in advance. I try to get to most of them, but this is the return stream, you know, for a little bit. And I know that it's going to...
You could answer Tiki Boom Boom about how your wife let you have all the toys.
I didn't see Tiki Boom Boom. I'm so sorry. Pretty much I said, please, can I have toy room? And she goes, no! And I go, please! And she goes, no! And I said, I'll let you have makeup. And she goes, okay! So that's how that went. But I, like I said, in normal streams and when I'm normally on, I try to answer all the stuff. And but I know I'm going to miss it. So I'm going to tell the story. For those of you that have just got here, that have never seen my stream, because I know that every day somebody's buying a PlayStation, somebody's logging on to see what the hell's going on. But I streamed for like 3 months at the beginning of the year, close to that. And people would come, we'd have a good time or whatever, and then I stopped. And it's been 66 days since I've streamed. And that's because I, add me away, man. And that's because I had health issues, and I had my gallbladder. And this is the story behind it. And so go ahead, write this down or whatever, but this is the honest to God true story. So, no. So, Friday night, now this isn't recent, this has been a little bit. So, Friday night, I eat Mexican food, and I knew that I had a problem with my gallbladder to begin with, and I had mentioned that in previous streams. But anybody who's never had gallbladder pain, anybody who has never had a gallbladder pain, they actually say that it's close to childbirth. I know, without the epidural. They say that it's on the level of that. Maybe not quite as bad. I wouldn't even want to say it's that bad, but some doctors, they actually say that it is. So anyway, I had gallbladder pain. And when you have that, you have stones inside your gallbladder, and it seizes up, and it starts to pulse, and it causes immense pain. And I say the word crippling because you can't sit, stand, lay, crouch. Nothing is comfortable. Nothing relieves it. And in the previous months, I had been able to do it with a hot shower or some medication or whatever and let the pain go away. This particular night, it wasn't. So I said, hey... what's up, cards? I said, hey, I have to go to the hospital. So I went to the ER, and they gave me morphine, and it didn't release it. It didn't let it relax so that I could actually get some sleep and let this thing calm down. So the hospital says, well, everything looks good. Go home. And I'm like, I'm still in pain. They're like, all right, whatever. Go home. So I go home, and 5 hours later, I find myself back into a different ER. While I'm in there, I'm still in the same amount of pain. That gallbladder is just squeezing down, and it's just immense, crippling pain. And that started probably like 1 a.m. So it's like Saturday morning, 1 a.m. That's when this started. And so I go to the hospital probably around 5 o'clock Saturday afternoon. So there's your time span. It's the time I get to the second ER room. They do all these tests, CAT scans, blood work, all this stuff again. And they say, all right, well, your gallbladder is in really bad shape. We have to admit you to the hospital so that we can remove it. And I'm like, all right, let's do it. Get this bastard out of me. And I told this weird bearded Santa Claus looking doctor who had suspenders on. Not a lab coat, not that doctory lab coat. No, 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 no. This man had rainbow suspenders and a Santa Claus beard. And he's telling me there's something wrong. Anyway, so they admit me to the hospital. And they tell me that they can't do the surgery until the next afternoon. So all they can do is give me morphine and all Dilaudid and all this stuff that doesn't relieve the pain. And I'll get to why. And I know I'm missing all this stuff, and I'm so sorry. But I'm getting to it. I need to get this story out because I know a lot of people want to know where I've been. So I'm in the hospital, and they're pumping all this drugs and stuff into me, and it's not touching it. I didn't sleep at all. So the next day, the doctor comes in, blah, 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 we're going to do the surgery. And I'm like, well, let's do it. And he goes, well, I got to do these other ones first. And I'm like, come the hell on, man. So around noon Sunday, now remember, the gallbladder pain started at around 1 a.m., maybe a little, whatever, 1 a.m. Saturday morning. Sunday afternoon is when they finally put me under to take it out. That's how long it was constant pain. And the story's going to get a little graphic. So here we go. So they take the gallbladder out, send me back to the room. The doctor comes up and tells me what had happened. And my body had grown a golf ball size stone. And I wish that I was exaggerating, but he says it was that big. I have the paperwork to prove it. He said there was a golf ball size stone. And the stones are built like calcium buildup, so they're real jagged edge. So picture this tissued organ, you know, something kind of like your skin, being wrapped around this spiked golf ball. And the golf ball had actually been moved to the back of the gallbladder and halfway died around it. So when it seized up, it seized around this spiked, jagged ball, and it was just in this constant flux of pain. And he said it was one of the biggest he'd ever removed. And I was like, you ever seen a dead gallbladder? He said, yeah, there was one that was completely dead, but I got the half dead around the golf ball.
That guy was 80 years
old. Right. And for those of you that are wondering, no, gallbladder are in my condition is not normal. It just happened that my body was like, you know what, we're going to make a big old golf ball. And then that just messed me up. So 4 days in the hospital for this, you know, recovery, and it's all liposcopic. So I have four incisions all in my body, and they're all painful. So the doctor says, all right, 2 weeks off. You can't go to work. Nothing to do around the house. So 2 solid weeks, I couldn't do anything. So the second week, I go back to the doctor, and I say, yeah, you know what? It actually hurts when I breathe. And, oh, hang on, let me do that. So in between my return, I go to the ER again because it actually cuts off my breathing, and I have these quick breaths, and I cannot get a full breath because there's so much pain, and my lung cannot expand. So I go to the ER 8 days after my original surgery. So I go back to the ER, and they do all the tests, and this other weird doctor with this weird curly mustache, like the crazy stuff you would see like back in the 1800s, and I know this is the weirdest hospital ever, but he has this weird curly mustache. He does all these tests, and he goes, well, you got some fluid. And I go, what the hell does that mean? He goes, well, hopefully your body absorb it. And I go, can you do anything? He goes, nope, go home. The hell? So I go to my doctor's appointment, and I tell my doctor what had happened. He looks at all the tests, blah, 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 and he goes, well, you know what? Another week off. Don't do anything for a week. Don't pick up anything over 10 pounds. Don't even go upstairs. Just hang around down in the weird, misty stuff. And so I did. And I went back. That's 3 weeks of nothing, right? Doing absolutely nothing. Can't do anything. And I got this pain. And he says, well, the fluid's not gone. And I go, well, that's not good, is it? He goes, nope. We're going to give you a drain. Let that sink in for just a second. We're going to give you a drain. So what he does is he calls another doctor and he says, hey, doc, we got to put a drain in this douche. And I'm like, all right. So they have to run more tests on me, more blood work and all this stuff. And finally, I get in to see this doctor. And this is what I call the inception needle. So in order to find the spot inside where this collection of fluid had been, and they don't know what the fluid is made of until they get in there. So they just know there's fluid through all the CAT scans. So to get in there, I have to lay sideways on a CAT scan machine. And they run me in, and then the doctor goes, all right, here. And he pulls me back out, and he takes this needle that is this long, and I swear to God, I wish I was joking. He takes this that has, hang on. So he takes this big needle, and he sticks it in, and I am awake the whole time. Granted, it's numbed, you know, and I got some stuff going in, but I feel this needle. So it goes in a little bit, and then he runs me into the CAT scan machine. And he goes, all right, and he pulls me back out. He goes, a little bit more, and I feel this needle go inch by inch into this weird abyss of my body, and finally goes, all right, and he attaches this turkey basting damn needle syringe thing on the end of the needle, and he goes, and he pulls out, that thing was that thick, right, that thick, and the whole thing is filled with this black green milky liquid, and he goes, yep, that was what was in you. And he takes two of those out, and what that was is bile, blood, and other secretions inside my body that had built up from where the gallbladder had started to die. So all this time it was just leaking down inside. I mean, gallbladder's gone. They took it out, but all that stuff was just left down in there. So he takes the needle, sucks as much of the shit out of there as he can, and then he runs a tube into the body, right? Pulls the needle out around it or whatever, and then they give me a bag, a drain bag. That's what it's called, a drain bag that had to be drained twice a day. He inserted the needle in between my bottom two ribs, okay? So picture that. Picture your bottom two ribs, and that hose went through there in all the way to my midsection, and then the tube came out about a foot and a half long into a bag that I couldn't go anywhere without constantly for a week. So after a week of having this blood fluid stuff pulled out of me constantly, the doctor says, all right, I'm going to remove it. The main doctor, the gallbladder doctor, he says, all right, I'm going to remove the bag. And I'm like, all righty, do I need a driver? He goes, no, no, no. And I'm like, all right, so it's going to be like a local anesthesia. And that was my intent. You know, go there, they give me a little tap in the vein, and I'm like, he numbs the area. And then he slowly pulls the tube out. No, that's not how they do it. That's not how they do it. What they do is they lay me down, put me on my side. He pulls this Band-Aid off that had been on there for so long. And that hurt, number one. And then this tube is just sticking out of the side of me. I mean, it's a tube that goes in, and it's freaky looking, okay? So there's this tube sitting there, and then he goes, all right, take a deep breath. And I go, hey, shouldn't I get something in here, you know, something little that make me feel a little better? And no. He says, all right, take a deep breath. I go, like that, take a deep breath. And he goes, all right, exhale. When I exhaled, he goes, and pulls that tube right out of the center of me, and I felt every inch of that just go right out, like a weird-ass fishing rod. It was creepy. Anybody that had ever had stitches removed know what I'm talking about. That burn that you feel when they remove the stitch real quick, you know, so it doesn't bleed and it sort of cauterizes it, that came from inside, whipped out. He puts a Band-Aid on and says, go back to work. Yeah. Swear to God, real deal. That is the real story. He says, well, no restrictions, go back. I had been laid up for over a month solid. Couldn't do anything. He rips this bag out, throws a weird Band-Aid on, says, go back to work. No! And I know I missed so many comments, but that is a real story. There's a lot of other things that happened in between, and I know that I'll pop on and tell more about it. But that's the real whole story of it. And I hate that I had to tell it, but that's why I haven't been on. The recovery road had been so up and down when it was only supposed to be like a week of, you know, normal pain, taking medicine and getting better, and then a week of doing normal activity with little soreness. And it wasn't like that. It was this weird up and down, and I know I missed other parts of it. I had to go back to the hospital another time, and I stayed in there for two nights at that point. It was just really bad all over. It was not good. I don't recommend it. So, here is my tip to all of you out there. I don't care how many are watching. It could be 10 people. Listen, if you have a gallbladder pain, all right? If you have this, and you know it, you know if you do, because you can't do anything but cry. That's all you can do with gallbladder pain. So if you have that pain, you go to the ER. They said, well, your gallbladder's got to come out. They're not going to do it that night, because generally it's going to happen in the middle of the night, somewhere around 12 or 1 a.m. They're not going to do it right then. They say, you need to go, because they're going to give you some good stuff. They're going to give you some morphine. They're going to right then say, all right, tomorrow, when you feel better, make an appointment to get it removed. You fucking know it! All right? You do it! You make that appointment! Because if not, you're going to end up with a drain bag! Does that sound sexy? No, it doesn't. It is impossible to get laid with a drain bag. Impossible. Because everybody goes, oh, that's a colostomy bag. I bet you pee in that because you're incontinent. No, it's blood, which makes it worse. Didn't go anywhere for a week because I had this damn thing going around. Oh, I'm so sorry that I missed everybody's comments. But that's it. That's the true story. So let me go back to the apple cider vinegar. So that night, that Saturday night, Friday night, Saturday morning, I'm trying to fight this off, right? And in the past couple of months, I had had apple cider vinegar tea with honey. And that seemed to relax it because apple cider vinegar is one of those, for some reason, the acid in it helps relax the gallbladder. And though my wife had made it for me, okay, but I didn't want to wake her up, you know. I didn't want to bother her with my crippling problems because I'm a dude, and for some reason, dudes think that's okay. So she'd made it before in the past, and I'm like, you know what? I'm a dude, and I don't want to bother, so I'm going to make my own tea. And what I did is I made it really apple cider vinegary strong, which don't do that. So I got this weird concoction. I'm chugging it down, hoping it's going to relieve this, which in the end, I didn't know this, but it wasn't going to because it was dead. I let the pain go, I let the pain continue on, and I'm trying to fight through, and then I started vomiting, which, if you don't know this, if you have gallbladder pain, you start to vomit, that is a bad sign. That is a key that you have to go to the ER right then. So the first couple of things was, you know, kind of foodie, you know, and I know you guys are going to love this story, and eventually it stopped being foodie, and it ended up being very vinegary. And if anybody's ever drank that, and my buddy Ross in here, or Russ, he said that he does, you know, for, you know, weight maintain and all that.
That's like a tablespoon in orange juice.
Yeah,
he does.
the 2.5 shots of apple cider vinegar that I had came flowing back up, worse than drinking it, because you can't stop. And it was really bad. So like I said, if you have gallbladder pain, go directly to the ER, make your appointment, and get that sumbitch taken right out.
Do not collect your money.
Get the hell out of here. Thank you, WWF man. All right, we're going to get back to this, do a little bit more talking. But that's the true story.
Here.
Huh?
McFly's in here.
I saw you, McFly. I didn't get to say hi. What is going on, man? How's your band doing?
And Buckers, find your Instagram.
Oh, Buckers, it's right here, buddy. Right there, man, if you're still in here. Down syndrome, midget cum bucket, want to be my bitch. You should have had a question mark at the end of that. Because if not, that's just a statement. Follow, great show. Thank you very much, man. But yeah, that's the true story. That is the actual story. There's a lot of stuff that happened in between, you know, that makes it funnier or better or whatever. But I wanted to get to the facts tonight because it's been so long since I've been on, and I know that some people follow my Instagram, they know, but it's so hard to get that whole story out through typing. It's almost impossible, and you don't know the inflections, you don't know all that kind of stuff. So I wanted to let you guys know that's what it is. I'm going to try not to talk about it anymore because I know that it's semi-gross. But like I said, if you have any of that stuff, if you have any of those syndromes, get right down to it. Take that sumbitch out. Me and my twin sister are 21 today. Well, that's awesome, man. Happy birthday. That is great. What is, BX bomb dead ass? I like that. I like that. It's this crazy name, but he's like real sincere about it. So, let's find something else to play with. Ooh, here we go. This will piss off some collectors because that's what I'm all about. So this figure is from, I think it's 1996. So I'm going to open up a figure from 1996. Been in the package the whole time. And no, I didn't. Reading Rainbow, yeah, me too, dude. LeVar Burton's one of those people that, you know, helped raise the community. Will do, that's right, buddy. So this has been in the package, and it's the red lightsaber for those of collectibles. But this has been in the package since 1996. That is almost 20 years that somebody had this and go, you know, I'm not going to open that. Well, I'm going to open it. So you met Dr. Santa Claus and yes, not the Whiplash. Exactly. It was so creepy. But, you know, I'm in all this immense pain, and I'm just looking at him like, am I imagining this? It was just, it was like some weird trippy thing that I couldn't get off of. Glad it turned out. Yeah, I mean, I still have a little bit of pain, but, I mean, it's better, and I don't have a bag. Thank you, buddy. So like I said, this has been in the package for 19 years, okay? 19 years. Crossfire! You can make a lot of new characters with a story. I know, right? Snidely Whiplash or something. Be like, let's take out your gallbladder. Or something weird. The king is back, Super Dave. So, here we go. 19 years this has been in the package. And, you know, some of these actually have value to them, but I don't give a damn. And for some reason, some weird place decided to stick $20 price tag. These figures were $5 back in the day. I don't know who this guy is. Doing really good. Thanks a lot. Awesome. That is so good to hear. Hey, the voice will return, buddy. Don't worry. That's great to hear. Sorry, eyes half asleep. It is all good, Buckers. Dude, it's great to see you again. Thank you, buddy. Really pleased to see you back. Glad you're feeling better. I know, McFly. I'm glad to be feeling better, too. It's good to be back. It's good to see all you guys again. I know it's not see, but you know what I'm talking about. So let's open this. But there you go. It's got the weird information card. And I don't really know if they do those anymore. You know, it's got all this storyline on it. And then all the other figures that you can buy, too. Good to have you back. Thank you very much, Tenacious. No! There we go. Those are the guys that I wanted. Those are the guys. Jurassic World. Oh, I haven't seen it yet, but I want to go see it. That's probably going to be something I'm going to do really soon because I really want to. No! I know, right? Like I said, if my buddy Darkseid was in here, he would totally be pleased with this. But since Sunday Heat is in here, we're going to do it for him, and that way he can go, oh! Yeah! So, this, for those of you guys who don't know, this is Han Solo in Carbonite, and I actually had this figure as a kid, and I opened it because, you know, I'm a kid and I want to play with it. Wee bag! There he is, and this is, you know, just from Return of the Jedi and Empire, and it's actually really cool, especially for a 90s figure, to be able to have, you know, the stickers on the inside, and actually it looks good. It's well painted and nice. So, there's Han right there. You will never open my He-Man! Maybe you should. Thank you very much. Thank you, man. Next month, I'm going to buy Nightwing toy. Oh, sweet, sweet. Send me a picture. I want to see what it looks like. Are you back? Sub back! What's going on, man? One of your auctions? What? What are you talking about?
They probably sell for a lot of money. You just open something.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I get what you're saying. Yeah. That's sold for a ton of those. Oh, yeah, I know. I know. It's insane. But, I mean, literally, I just bought this like a couple weeks ago for $5. So there's Han out the box. I mean, it's a good sculpt. These were all the...
Darkseid's in there.
The Kenner. These are all the Kenner big buff ones. So everybody looked like they were just jacked on steroids. But it looks good. And he actually comes with a blaster. And it's not even really Han's blaster, so I don't know whose this is. Maybe it's something he picked up on Sky City or not. Don't open! I bet there's a psych. Carl! I bet there's a psych after that. So there's this weird blaster. And like I said, that's not Han's. I don't know who that is. But one of the greatest things about it is that Han actually clipped into the back of the Carbonite. See? He actually clipped in the back, so you can actually display this and be like, no, he's really in there. Don't worry. And I wonder if I can keep the gun in there, too, because that would be real freaking handy. Got a screenshot for Darkseid. There you go. Actually, he's in here. That's what I just saw, right? Bust the back off that mother! Highly recommended. Yeah, I know. I heard it was really good. As soon as I saw that trailer last year, when the park is open, I was like, they did it. Like, they made a sequel worth a damn. I like Lost World. I thought Lost World was really good, but that third one was just crap. What is up, Click Commander? Tell you what, Click Commander, give me one second, man. I got something for you. Yeah, cool. He can hold it. He can hold the gun in the back. So that's a contained figure with accessories. Dude, my buddy still has that figure. Did he open it? Because that's what I do. Stay. Stay. There you go, Click Commander. That's for you, buddy. Right there. You should know exactly who they are, man. I am the Clit Commander! See, I got a little bit of something for everybody. Later, Superman, I saw you. Clancy, dude, I know you're out there. It's so late there. Thank you, buddy. Ark Carrier, I have a double cheeseburger, 19 years old. Open it! Open it! Sing the Reading Rainbow. You sing it for me. I've been talking for a while. Oh, you need a dollar. I know. You got to give me a dollar. You owe me one. Whiskey Mystic. Your shirt reminds me of a nightmare ahead. What was your nightmare, man? Tell me all about it. I'm curious. I got to know. Let's find something else to play with. These I'm not going to open. I hesitated. I went back and forth on it, but I'm not. They're not that collectible. They're not that rare, but I really like it. Sweet, that is so good to hear, dude. That is so good to hear that you're finally getting it. Because I know that it's got to be one of those great things when you're singing all the classic stuff. Like, you feel it, and you're there. You're just like, yeah, so that's good to hear. Han has D-144 made from Mauser. Oh, you're talking about the gun. Okay, I got you. A tear has dropped. Hey, listen here, Average. Do not worry, man. There is so much stuff. All right, look, there's so much stuff that is still in cases, that is still in boxes. Don't worry, man. Hello, what is up? Terminator Genisys thoughts. They just need to stop with the Terminator. I love the first Terminator. T2 is the best. Thank you, Gimme Booze. What's up, dude? How you doing? Have you missed Mad Max? Oh, yeah, I haven't seen it yet. I heard it's great, though. Like I said, I've been stuck inside. I've been stuck to the bag. What is up, Darkseid? About time you popped in here. But yeah, the Terminator, they just need to stop. Think of something new, Hollywood. Stop it. I just told you a story about a weird suspender beard doctor and some sniggly, sniggly mustache guy. Make a movie! Oh, there you go. See, I knew you'd be down with it. Blunt, there you go, J-Dub. But these are not going to open. I went back and forth. But these are Micro Machines that came out for Back to the Future. And this is the Back to the Future 2, sorry. And this is the hover port, you know, the Texaco, because that's still big. Yeah, it's 2015 when the movie is set, and Texaco was the main thing. You don't ever see Texaco. So there it is. This is just the pad. You know, this is just, you know, what you saw in the movie. And these were Micro Machines. And the reason I didn't want to open this is because it's not punched. See, if you look at the top, this means it's never hung on a peg. So somebody got this fresh out the box and decided to keep it. And I'm a huge Back to the Future collection fan, so I'm not. And I got these to go with it. And these are the Micro Machines. That is the DeLorean. And that is the cop car from Back to the Future 2. And it's punched, but I'm like, they kind of go as a set, and that's all they made. They didn't make any others. These are the only two, and I got them in the package. They're going to go into my Back to the Future collection. That's what it is. Nerd! Very good, Drabeast. Very good. Got a samurai. Oh, went away. Figure worth 2G. Nice! Hope you're back to yourself, man. Mr. Breen, I'm trying so hard to be myself again. It's very difficult. Yo, I saw your dark side. I saw you hanging out in there, man. Going to my comic shop tomorrow. Oh, no, man. It is so hard. Like I said, I haven't been on, but I still keep collecting. Just open it. No, not with those, man. Do you have any Lord of the Rings toys? Daddy Sugar, no, I don't. I can't get into the mystical, magical, wizardy stuff. I really can't. It's so hard. Harry Potter does not appeal to me. And Lord of the Rings really doesn't appeal to me. I haven't seen the new ones. The Hobbit, I didn't see any of those. I like the second Lord of the Rings. But they don't appeal to me. I was eating. Oh, you're good, dude. Don't worry, man. Don't worry. I started so late. I had so many technical difficulties. Do not worry. Are you getting Batman? I am. Go, bad. Okay. No, I know. Let me do to 1:30, because I started even later than that. So, yo, Darkseid, new Terminator looks terrible. I agree, Vinny. I really do. I think I just need to stop. Terminator is not hip anymore. It's not cool. T2 is where it should stop. But you're good, Darkseid. Don't worry, man. pull them Universal Air Mags. They're right there, man. You can see them. I don't have to get them closer. Did you hear Arnold wants J.J. Watt to be... What? They just need to stop. They need to stop. Yeah, exactly, Freddy. Back to the Future is my number one movie. I love 1, I love 2, I love 3. I love them all. That is my go-to movie. I have seen them all three probably over 200 times each. Like, it's my go-to movie. If it's on, like, I'm flipping through the channels, that's what I go to is Back to the Future. Like, yep, I don't care what else is on. That or Gone in 60 Seconds with Nicolas Cage. I don't know what it is about that movie. Maybe it's the soundtrack. I couldn't even tell you, but I absolutely love those movies. There's a lot of other ones, too. So, you know what? I really want to open this. And I've had this for a long time. I'm going to do this, a loot crate, and then we're probably done. So I've had this for a while, and... I mean, I paid retail price for this. I mean, well, jacked up stuff. I had those micros as a kid. That's awesome. See, that's what I love about this show. That's what I love about interacting with people. Because it's like I find the stuff out there in the wild, and I bring it into my collection. I show it, and it's something you haven't thought about for 10, 15, 20 years. And all of a sudden, you're like, dude, I had that. That's why I do the Instagram thing. That's why I hang out on Instagram, because... Everybody has a collection. It doesn't have to be this. It doesn't have to be comic books on the wall. It doesn't have to be DVDs or figures. If you collect something, more often than not, you're going to have something that's going to spark somebody's childhood, and they're going to be like, oh, man, even if it's a keychain, a T-shirt, a video, you know, even a movie they haven't seen in so long, it's going to spark them, and it's going to make it, it's going to cause that join thing, that joined nerd circle. That's what that's all about. That's what the nerd circle really is. It's joining people that in any other circumstances never would have met, ever. Like Darkseid right there. Like, that guy lives so far away from me. I never in this world ever would have ran into him. It would be impossible. But through this, I get the chance to hang out and talk with these people who have common interests, common loves, and it is so good to be able to do that. Evening! What is up, Stratosphere? I remember you, buddy. Great to see you again. Yeah, me too, Que so. Glad you're back. Feel like you weren't away that long, mate. Yeah, I was 66 days, Mr. Bren. So I've had this for a very long time, and I really want to open it, and I think that I have earned this. So this is the, I can't remember how to say it. It starts with a K. Koba Tukuki, the Bushido statue. But this is Lucy, and this is the sexy, torn-up Ghostbuster statue. She's not a figure. She's a statue. She's always going to be in this pose right here. But this is their take on the sexy Ghostbuster. And I know this is going to blow some of your minds. And it's like I said, I paid retail for it. I didn't get no good deal on it. But I really, really, really want to open it. Arnie is doing... Yes, I don't even care if Arnie's in it. Indiana Jones 5. I'm down with that one, Headshot. Aww. And the box is all in pristine condition, and I remember it came with all this foam insulation around it, and I'm like, I don't even care. So let's see if we can get this out without really doing a lot of damage. Oh, that wasn't bad at all. Yeah, the crash test dummies. Yeah, see, that's something else. I don't remember where I saw it, but I'm like, I've got to have some crash test dummies. Even though the one that I got happened to be from 2002, and I didn't even know they made crash test dummies into the 2000s. So apparently it's got instructions. I bought the Walking Dead Governor books. Oh, that is awesome, man. These right here that are behind my head, I know have been blocking it. Those are the trades of Walking Dead. That's all I read. I don't really even collect the... Like I said, it's too expensive. You like Game of Thrones? Yeah, Daddy, and I know what you're going to say instantly. I'll be like, well, that's mystical, magical. Yeah, but there's tits in it. So there you go. You lose. So here's the base that comes with Lucy. And it's actually really heavily detailed. That's really cool. It's got the Ghostbuster symbol and a trap that just sits there. Oh, I was kind of hoping the trap would open. Oh, it doesn't. Damn it. If I push, no. But there's the trap. It sits, and it's got the peg holes for her to stand. One thing about these Kaboko statues, and I know... J-Dog, what's up? One thing about these... don't open it. I know, man. These Kaboko statues is... they make them, and this is going to sound so pervy, but you're going to like it because you're dirty guys just like me. But they make the skin look so soft. And I know that's real pervy, but they really do. So this is Lucy out the box. And she's got that weird anime eye. And I know you guys are going to give me some major hell about anime stuff. But it just looks sexy. And it's, you know, like I said, the skin just looks soft. It's not. Not even the head or anything. But that's Lucy. She's got the torn up pants. Not even a thong, so you can actually show it on here. But it's not a figure. It's a statue. Nothing moves on her. Nothing changes. But I like the way the proton pack looks. Like, they put some work and some detail in that. So I think it's cool. And she goes on the base. Somehow, a little wide stance. There we go. Yeah. Stands on the base. Looks good. Clicks in there. Show that other... No! Freddy and Jason status like that. I have the Freddy and Jason... Oh, you're talking about the girls. Yeah. I almost bought the Jason one. I thought it would look really good. The Freddy one's not bad either. But I went with Lucy just because I'm a bigger Ghostbusters fan than I am anything horror. See, like I said, it's more nerdy than anything. There's a vinyl... Pop Stay Puff. I know, right? Dude, Pops are blowing up with everything, and I hated Pops when they first came out. I'm like, that's so stupid. What a waste of money. And now I buy them all the damn time. Looks better out the package. I agree. I think they did a good work on the package, but overall, the statue looks so good. And the statue is pretty much the same price in or out the box. So here is the blaster, and I know it has a name, and I've just been awake for a while. I can't remember what it is. The stick... And, it, I mean, that's highly detailed, you know? It really is. And it's got the cable that runs all the way to the pack, and she actually holds it. So that's cool. I don't know where it plugs in. Perhaps, there it goes. If I didn't throw the instructions, I would know. So that goes all the way around, and she can hold it. I hope. Please. So, let's move on. My foot smells. Oh, see? That's what I'm talking about. That's what I miss so much about these people. I hate to say this, and do not take this out of context, but I so forgot about my foot smells. Oh, dude, it's so good to see you, dude. It's been way too long. It really has. Anyway, so she holds this. She holds the gun, and that goes in there a lot easier without the damn cable. And she comes with a little pair of goggles. Thank God for super glue. Dead ass! let's see. And I guess they go on her head. So she comes with a little pair of goggles, kind of like Ray had in the movie. And that's neat. Maybe they don't go on her head. Maybe she holds them. I don't know where they go. Because her head, and don't take this out of context, but her head is really big. See? Big old head. Little bitty pair of goggles. Don't really fit. And that looks stupid. So I don't know where they go. Who makes the statue? It is Kabotu? Kabuku? Kabatu? I don't speak, there it is, right there. That word right there, Kodabukiya. That's what you Google, but you could actually Google just Ghostbuster statue and Lucy on eBay or Google, and that's, you'll get the same thing. But like I said, I don't speak Japanese, so I can't tell you exactly how to say that. But that's all that comes with her. Like I said, it's a statue, not a figure. And I like it. I think it looks really good. It's one of those sexy things, you know. It just has that look. And, you know, the torn up jeans, that just adds to it. Me too, same with Family Guy. Hated the show, now love the show. Yeah, it's so weird, right? It's so weird. Are you into Minecraft? No, not at all. This is my statement on Minecraft. If you want to play it, fine. Don't brag about it unless you're 9 years old. That's fine. It is a child's game. That is what it stands for. If you want to go build that stuff in your weird thing, fine. I'm not going to make fun of you, but Minecraft is kind of for kids. That's what I think about it. Go play something badass, like Batman. So this loot crate came to me. Let's see if I got it. I didn't say. 2 months ago, because the new one, that's sweet. I know, right? This came to me 2 months ago. This is the loot crate. I never opened it because I didn't feel good, and I was just like, I just threw it up here. I didn't even care. Black Clown, what's up, man? I like that name. I like the name Black Clown. Where have you been for 3 weeks? Salt Life, you totally missed the story. I had major surgery and a lot of complications. So let's open this and find out what's in the loot crate. Yo, how much you pay for the Marty McFlys? Not as much as you think. So let's open this. And like I said, I don't know what's in it. It's got like a treasure chest and a t-shirt, looks like. Those of you who had Loot Crate already know. Salt Life, I've been off for 66 days. Yo, oh, I already saw that. It's a dragon. I don't know what that is. I don't know. It's some kind of dragon and an at symbol. So it's at dragons? I don't know. It's odd, but it's not a bad t-shirt. Their t-shirts are pretty good. We got... Oh, that's cool. Princess Bride playing cards. That's kind of neat. I actually like that. That's something kind of cool. You like Elder Scrolls? Oh, yeah. Oh, see, I know I said the mystical, magical, but when I get to do it, it's a little different. See, when I get to cast spells and stuff, you know, that's a little different than having to watch, you know, Harry Potter. Oh, the weird Snape guys behind me. Let's see what else we got. We got Game of Thrones Stark Sigil flash drive. That's interesting.
How many gigs on?
I don't know.
Usually it says on the thing.
Made in China. Doesn't say. I don't know. But it's got the Stark, the Dire Wolf. That's really cool. And it's a USB. I'll be damned. You can plug it in, find out. Later. Let's see what else we got. We got the button. Side sheep. I know, right? What about... That Lucy is 120 online. How much did you pay? I paid 80.
I'm sure it's probably only two.
So, there's a button that comes with all the loot crates. Loot crate time! I know, right? Harry Potter. Not the 9 3/4, that weird train thing. It is a luggage tag? Bag tag.
Just give it to me, I'll take it.
So it's a luggage tag. You can put that on your luggage.
Or I can use it as a bookmark.
It's solid.
And?
There you go. You can't have the Stark. You can't have the Stark flash drive, though. I don't know what this is. It's something... Fantasy! Is that what this is? This is the fantasy crate? Like I said, it's been so long since I've done anything. It blows up. It's inflatable! It's a crown! Oh!
That makes sense. It's a Dungeons & Dragons symbol.
Okay, Dungeons & Dragons t-shirt. Okay. That's one thing. I always wanted to play Dungeons & Dragons because it looks so cool, but there's so much stuff involved. So many rules and math and all that. Ah, I can't do it. I would like to watch it. Elder Scrolls. Oh, it's the Elder Scrolls. I don't know. Sup, I like how the room looks. Thank you, buddy. There we go. Now that's sexy. Who the hell they designed this for? Probably not my big ass head. Made in China. You still doing Villains Brawl? Maybe soon, man. Not this one. This is sort of like the comeback. We may get into it. Not sure. Tommy Jojo, what's up, man? Good to see you again. My mom told me I'm made in China. Oh, okay. That's what it is. Dungeons & Dragons. I agree. I love Pog. Oh, no. All right, let's move on. We got Game of Thrones magnets. Ah, that's cool. See, I'm a huge Game of Thrones. Like I said, if you haven't seen it, I'm not going to spoil anything. But I absolutely love Game of Thrones. They can do a lot of wrong, but in the end, it seems to be for the best. So we'll just go ahead and cry now and weep later.
Team White Walker!
But there we go. It's magnets. So that's kind of cool. Anything that's got Game of Thrones stuff, I dig. I dig a lot. That's neat. And it's a bow tie! Have you got any Playboy magazines? I do, man. I do. Some of the older ones I have. I actually have, like, Madonna's when she was in Playboy. That's a singer from the 80s. Good night, guys. Trent Zorg, man. You're one of my dudes. Thank you so much for popping in, man. How big is growing... Oh, that's funny you mentioned that. Here, let me throw this on. I'll tell you. So, we got a bow tie. Let me see what it's got on it. Little Dragons! It's got the die right there, like for Dungeons & Dragons, and Little Dragons. So it's a freaking bow tie. And anybody that knows me knows that I actually dig bow ties more than any other form of fashion wear.
Because you're cool.
Because I'm cool, right? So it's got a little Dungeons & Dragons bow tie. I like that. Nice crown! I know, right? The Saints, I might send it to you. So, for those of you who haven't been here ever, King Nerd, you will like the next crate. Yeah, I got it sitting right there. For those of you who don't know, I started doing this robot, and we named him, I can't remember the damn name, something about Thunder Lips. It was something like Thunder Guppy. That's what his name was. And I put him in this bowl of water. He's this little thing that grows, and like he expands with water. And I had him in the bowl, and he got like this, like he started out like this big. And he got this big, and I would come up here, and I'd be like, oh, there he is in the bowl. Eventually, the water all evaporated. I didn't even notice it until today when I was just cleaning up a little bit. And he has actually shrank back down a little bit. So this is Thunder Guppy right there. So I guess I got to restart it. We might do that in a later stream, you know, see what it's like. I'm a huge D&D, a few people doing it on Ustream. Really? That's cool, Gimme Booze. That's awesome. See, I love the idea of Dungeons & Dragons. I really do, but there's so much math and thought process and building. Like, if I could just create a character and go on the journey and not have to do anything, you know, just kind of like, all right, well, now I actually win. You know, that would be cool to me, but other than that, maybe soon, Tommy. I'm not sure, man. So anyway, Thunder Guppy's back in the dry bowl. My two sons would love your room. sometimes I come in here and it's actually a little bit overwhelming. But let's see what else we got in the bottom of the loot crate. It is the book. That's the book that tells about everything. 4 gigs. It's a 4 gig hard drive.
Oh, cool.
That's not bad.
I remember when those used to be like $70.
Something free. Yeah. Yeah. So this is the book. It comes with all of them. And then in the bottom, it's got this cool shield. I actually like that. I dig the shield. I might actually save that shield because it's kind of neat looking. I'm a huge fan of all that. I know that I don't like the mystical stuff, but I do like lineage. You know, back in the day, whenever you would, you know, learn your family crest and all that, I love that. And it kind of looks like one. Yeah, I know, right? The funny thing about that, Sobek, is in the Madonna issue is that she had two spreads in it. I guess because she's the big 80s star. And they're like, we'll do whatever you want. I don't care.
Actually, these were pictures she took before she was somebody. And then whoever took them okay. Called them to Playboy.
Makes sense. But anyway, so she has one spread where she's just hot, sexy Madonna. And then she has the other one where she's dirty, stinky Madonna. She has armpit hair, full bush, half leg. Chewbacca going on, man. David, what's up, buddy? You got a new name, I see. Good to see you. I pop in your streams every once in a while, man. I don't say anything. I just kind of low, but it's always good to hang out in the 420 club. I've been really sick, man. I had some major surgery and a lot of complications. Can't blow up my crown. Oh, I'm sorry, Dark. But yeah, that's the crown that came with it. I kind of dig it, but it's a little tight. It's cutting off the circulation, and so's the tie. I don't know if I can get it off. Nope. Well, maybe. Nope, it's stuck. I have a tie forever. There we go. Ha. Hey, wait. Oh, you dirty bitch. Forever a virgin. Man, I wish. Sometimes it'd be like, you know what? It'd be nice to have that, you know, the bliss of having sex for the first time. It'd be so great. Let's see here. Hopefully so, Jizzy. Let me know. Add me, please. I will, Tommy. I promise. See you later, Jizzy. I know, Heroes, dude. Thank you so much. You were always on there talking to me through PlayStation, and it did mean a lot to me. I know that anybody that sent me messages outside of, you know, mainstream Instagram, it always made me feel better. You know, somebody out there is actually thinking about me. Doober, what's up, man? It always made me feel better. It lifted my spirits. And Heroes, you're one of those guys, and I thank you so much. Killa, thank you, man, for hanging out. Let me open these. I'm curious about these. And then I know I got to wrap it up. So these are the Game of Thrones magnets, and don't get them next to my phone.
Don't get mixed with TV either.
Yeah, gimme. I do too. I got Sable and I got, what was her name? Tori or Terry or something like that. The hot blonde who posed with her. China, all those, because I was a huge wrestling fan back in the day. Potty Scotty! How you doing, dude? Chewbacca Bush, I know. Jeff Strab, what's going on, dude? How you doing, man? See you later, buddy. Thank you very much, Barry. I really appreciate it. Like I said, you're one of my guys. Have a dip for me, man. I have over 200 Game of Thrones and Lord of the Rings toys. That's awesome, Daddy. That is awesome. I have two Game of Thrones toys. I have Jon Snow and Tyrion. And I love them. I think they're great. I pick up a few more, but, like, Denise, like, she's all derpy in the face, so I can't have her. So I got to wait for them to come up with something else. Welcome back from me and Sky. Oh, thank you, man. Thank you so much. Queen Side Sheep, hope all is well. Potty, I'm feeling better. I'm doing better. I'm up. I'm moving around. So, yeah. Damn, you good now? I know, I am. So these are cool. These are all going to go in my fridge. I like these. I think these are neat. And actually, the top one even comes out. The symbol, the Game of Thrones symbol. That's cool. That's something to be kind of cool to like to put on your car. Oh, keep the magnets away from things. Man, I had my ankle crushed with a forklift about a year ago. Oh, my God. Oh, that is terrible, dude. Watch out for forklifts. They don't like you. But, yeah, I hate to wrap it up. Missed you, mate. Later, dude. Thank you, man. I hate to wrap it up so early because I know it's sort of like the small return, and it's been so long since I've been on. It has been 66 days. Think about this, Slim. Let me put this in your little thing. You say that I have no life, but you're watching me have no life. So put that in your memory banks. Nothing but love, man. Thank you, J-Dub. You know you're one of my guys. You're the guy that, you know, you're one of those dudes that got me through. It's like you're talking to me, you know, you're interacting with me. And it's not always about nerdy stuff. It's about life. So it actually makes it a little better. Even if we couldn't still. before I go, really good. Thank you. Thank you very much, Trenzor. You know you're my dude. You're my jester in the court. I don't know, man. I can't imagine having my ankle crushed, not being able to walk for a while. So, I mean, I think that I miss you too, Potty Scotty. I see you popping other streams be like, I want to say, nah, I'm not. I'm going to let him be. But, I mean, everybody has their own pain and everybody has their own different experiences. And I really don't want to compare my experience to anybody else's. I don't think that having my ankle crushed is something that I would trade to have the gallbladder or anything. I don't really want that. So, I mean, it's good you're doing good, but I don't want to trade it because, I don't know, it just seems bad. Can you and your wife do whip? Nah, 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 please! I don't know what that is. It doesn't sound like something I could do. Remember, I'm white. If it involves dancing or twerking, it doesn't work very well. It should be a game of cocks and titties. I know, right? I know. Whip, nane, nane, please. I don't know what that is. I really don't. It seems like you know what you're talking about. But, yeah, see, that's the thing. The mystical, magical stuff, it doesn't work for me. But when there's titties involved, it's like, okay, I'll watch. And it works. I know. But, yeah, guys, I do got to wrap it up. I know that it's, you know, some people might just be popping in here saying hey or whatever. But I'm going to do my best to maybe do another show soon. I'm not going to go back. It's awesome to see you too, Fraggle. I'm not going to be back in that normal schedule right away. Maybe get back into it. No promises or anything. But yeah, it has been amazing seeing some of the people that I forgot about. And I hate saying that. It makes me so mad that there's great people out there that sort of faded away in my mind. And then when your name pops up, it just, I was like, yes, there they are. It's so exciting and so good to see you. And, it's awesome. And like I said, if you want to continue it, you can always follow me on Instagram. I post, you know, close up pictures of the stuff that I open, the stuff that I get, the stuff that I collect. And I honestly love seeing your collections because I don't think that it's fair for you to come in and stare at my comic books and be like, well, that guy's just a douchebag showing his stuff off. No, I love seeing your stuff. I love seeing stuff that sparks my memory from when I was a kid. So back then, you don't know what I have, and I don't know what you have, but I'd love to see it. And as soon as you show me, unless you're modder, as soon as you show me, I'm going to go out and I'm going to buy the damn thing and be like, I can't wait to get it again. I want to see it. I want to hold that weird figure from 1986 in my hand again, like back there. You know, I want to hold those again. So please, If you want to follow me on Instagram, I would love it. Show me your collection. Show me your stuff. Spark my childhood, and I will do my damnedest to spark yours as well. So with all that said, I want to say thank you guys so much for tuning in tonight. I know it's a short stream. I know that it's good to be back. It feels so good to get out and talk to you guys and show you the stuff and interact. And more often than not, if you're new to this, I interact a lot more over here. But because it's been 66 days since I've been on, I really wanted to get the story out and talk to you guys. But before I go, let me tell you this. You have to support your streamers. There are amazing people out there. There aren't just the weird girls that twerk and then get banned. There aren't that. There are actually people who love doing this, who love getting out, who love sitting right here and entertaining you and interacting with you. So please go watch them. Interact. Say hi. Tell them Jizzy sent you. That's the way to do it. There are great people out there. Moneymaker, Nikki, Darkside. There are so many. David is awesome to go in there and chill in his stream. It is one of the best ones because it just feels like you're there, you know? Like, he is like, yeah, whatever, come on in, have a beer, you know, smoke some weed. It's cool, it's chill, it's fun. I know that I'm forgetting so many of them, and I'm not trying to call anybody out, but there is one in particular that you have to watch, and that is DeSaints Fan. Go watch DeSaints Fan. I'm not sure about his schedule. That's not what matters. If you're flipping through, you go watch DeSaints Fan. He is the hardest working streamer ever in the history of Ustream, in the history of anything. The man makes games. He wants you to interact. He wants you to guess. He makes the puzzles ups. They are awesome. They are so fun to interact and try to guess what he's trying to get you to do it. He's working on so many of the classic game shows. It's bringing back so much of my childhood watching GSN when it's starting to build back up and watching all that stuff from the 70s and the 60s and the 80s and all those random game shows. He plays those, and he is the hardest working man on Ustream. I don't care. I want 118 guys in his stream. So always, always pop in, say hi. I don't care what you do. Just say, hey, what is going on, DeSaints Fan? Please go watch that. It is awesome. Like a stormtrooper helmet. I don't know what that is. But I know I've been rambling. That's what I do. I constantly ramble. I constantly talk so much. But with all that said, with everything we've done tonight, with the long-ass buildup, I didn't mean for it to. That is the end of this show. Thank you. You all so much for hanging out with me, talking to me, and just having some fun over here. And honestly, you make me a better person. You make me actually enjoy this weird, stupid roller coaster that we call life. Thank you all so much, and I will be back as soon as I can. And I really appreciate y'all hanging out. Again, follow me on Instagram. SFox will definitely follow you and bother you. That is all for me. That is Side Sheep. That is the Weird Ginger Monitoring, and my name is Jizzy. This is the Nerdy Effect. Goodbye. Good cut.